Well, let me bring you up to date, just in case you missed last week's show. Doug Eichner got a great start, then had some electrical problems that required he stop a couple of times to fix them. William Yokley had the clutch on his Raptor go away on him right at the start, but once he got going, it cooled off and worked perfectly. He was the first ATV in at the end of the first lap. Tim Gillespie's Raptor also had clutch problems at the start, but that also went away. What didn't go away was some kind of fuel pickup problem that caused the Raptor to quit at least three times. Then, in his attempt to make up some lost time, Tim clipped a narrow canyon wall in Endo. The CT team of Stevenson and Delonte had even worse luck, as the two-time winners seized the two-stroke Honda's engine about halfway through the first lap. Hey, here comes Eichner now. Let's watch his pit. Away goes John Gregory.
What?
Where's Alan?
He's coming.
How did you guys...
Well...
What happened?
Well, we did like we planned. We got the start. We were in the lead.
Alan, baby.
Then about...
What's that? What I got to watch for?
It's real sand washy. You got to really watch the... Watch the rocks. Watch it.
This is the other Cycle Parts West team of Alan White and Denny Rudd. The race wears on as William and Kim continue to lead, with the team of Joshua Fredericks and Eric Hayes hounding them really hard, and the solo rider Mike Caffro right behind them. Both the teams of Eichner and Gregory and Bielman and Gillespie struggle to make up their lost time.
You need to come over here, Doug.
Meanwhile, we're back in the Yokley-Coonley pits waiting for Kim to finish his first lap. And then in comes Mike Caffro right on his tail.
That was a blast.
Good job, Kim.
So is it rough?
Not too bad. It's a little rocky.
Did you stay out of the dust pretty much? You have dust
not
free?
Not too bad, not too bad.
And the bike is working?
Yeah, it's working good. It's a blast.
That's the only miles you put on it, right?
Yep, first time I ever rode one.
Wow.
Liked it.
Works good. How's it compared to the Honda?
A lot more power. Ton more power. Seems to handle a little better.
You think so? Handle it even better? How about this weight, front, rear? Seem to be still light on the front?
Yeah, but just right. It's not trying to wheelie all the time, you know?
And is the engine trackable enough? I mean, you know, to be able to just not have to run through the gears all the time?
Roll on and off, you know?
But this was rough, wasn't it?
It wasn't that bad.
You don't think it was that rough?
Half of it was real rocky and rough. The other half was...
But you're in good shape. You look pretty good.
Not
you look
too
pretty
bad.
Good because nobody else is deciding to do two laps. Would you have wanted to go another lap?
I'm gonna after William
Are
does
you?
This lap.
Are you?
Yeah, we go back and forth.
No, but I mean, you're not gonna two in a row is what I meant. You could have done another
one? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. All right.
That was a blast.
With most of the teams now in for their second pit stop and starting their third of four laps, it's still the Doug Roll prepared Raptor of William Yokley and Kim Coonley in the lead, followed very closely now by Josh Fredericks and Eric Hayes. And if you remember, it was Josh that hounded Ron Orner for most of the Elsinore GP before wearing a blister on his thumb. Well, he's obviously got that blister thing taken care of. And Eric Hayes finished third in that race. Doug Eichner and John Gregory are running a good race now, but unable to make up any time on the leaders. And as for Steve Bielman and Tim Gillespie, although fast, they are continually plagued by the mysterious fuel starvation problem.